Hey everyone, it's Professor Kishbaugh. I want everyone to put on some yoga music and take a deep breath. Blow it out. There. All right, let me turn down my yoga music now. This is about the only thing that's getting me through everything. Hey everyone, I apologize for all the stress that everything has created. Things are really in uncertain times right now, and I think we talked about this the first week of class. We are in uncharted territory. The stock market is plunging, and then it gains 2,000 points back the next day, and then it plunges again. And the most important thing to look at is not the points, how many points it goes down, but look at the percentage. And for the first few weeks of the coronavirus and everything that was going on, the S&P stayed pretty steady, and so did the NASDAQ. Remember, the NASDAQ, those are tech stocks, okay? The Dow were all your industrial stocks. The NASDAQ were the tech stocks. And those were pretty steady. And they're not steady anymore. They're losing 5 to 10% now. So things are pretty grim in this, as far as the stock market goes. And we'll talk more about that. Pay attention to that. I'm always telling you to pay attention to the stock market because that's going to be the driving force. Announced Sunday night, the Fed, they decreased the interest rate. It's 0 to 0.2% right now. That's almost never happened. So we're in really uncertain times, and businesses and the federal government and anyone that's an investment, they don't know what's going to happen next. So in those difficult times, things panic. People panic. Or they get really, really fiscally responsible. Just today, this is Wednesday when I'm recording it, people are taking massive amounts of cash out of their stock portfolios and hoarding that cash. That's a very scary thing. So keep attention to that. Pay attention to that. If you are trading, make sure that you're aware of the things that are going on. But what this happens to our economy, it makes us feel less faith in the economy. Stores are closed, restaurants are closing. This is really going to be some tough times in the next few weeks. So pay attention and do the best that you can. Spend time with your family. Take this time if you've been asked to stay home from work, if you've been asked to, well, you've been asked to stay home from school now. We are going to do online and virtual resources for the rest of the spring term. So take it easy, take a deep breath. This is for your safety. This is for my safety. This is for our community's safety. We have a really, really strong community. We're very lucky that we have such a strong community. So let's everybody work together. So tomorrow you will have a Zoom call. That's on Thursday. I sent out an announcement right here. It's in your announcements right here. Here's the Zoom information. Zoom is available via app if you're using an iPad. An app on your smartphone, download the Zoom, Z-O-O-M app, and you're able to log in. You'll be able to see the screen. You'll be able to communicate with others. Everyone will be muted when you first come in. Let's make sure you're muted. And if you do need to speak, you can unmute and speak. What I'll do is I'll ask a few questions, and there's actually a feature in there where you can text message right into the Zoom and answer my question. And this is important for accountability because we're moving online now. I know that many of you are not crazy about online classes, so instead of just giving you a bunch of discussions and throwing more assignments at you, let's do the Zoom thing. Let's do this virtual thing. You can turn the camera off. I don't expect you to be on video, so if you're broadcasting from home or broadcasting from your office on your cell phone or on your iPad, you can turn the video feature off. I'll have the video feature on so you can see me. I'll share some information. I'll ask you guys some questions, and I'll only keep you about a half hour, no more than 45 minutes if we're in a good discussion. Okay, so I'm requiring you guys to do that. I've sent you the link for the next 7 weeks, and if it's Tuesday, Thursday, 2 p.m. to 2:30. I think everybody can manage that. You're supposed to be in class with me anyway, and you're gonna miss me. What can I say? And I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm gonna miss you guys, and not only am I gonna miss you, but I think some of the students that you've managed to really build this team rapport with, you're gonna miss them as well. That's the worst part about closing the campuses and canceling events, is now we're not encouraging that communication and that college spirit. So let's try to do as much of that as we can online. If there's a piece of music you want to share on the Zoom call tomorrow, or if there's an article you want to share or something about your life, I don't care if we spend a half an hour talking about how the cats and dogs are dealing with all the corona stress, okay? Because we're angry and we don't want to yell at our cats and dogs. So I know that my humor doesn't translate as well on the computer, on the video, but I'll try to make it as light and as I can. So take it easy. I know that my family is struggling because there is absolutely no sports on TV. So I know those of you guys that go to the Lightning games, you guys are gotta get to my Lightning. You know, the seasons are canceled. There's no basketball. Baseball isn't even starting. So for those of us who like sports, we don't even have that outlet right now. So basically just settle back, pay attention. I'm going to send some instructions, but I like you guys. I have this podcast I follow. Right now, we're going to be talking about social change and social corporate responsibility. And I like this podcast. It's called Teaching Change. Now, it's a podcast done by one of my colleagues at Valencia College, and he's a professor. So a lot of the episodes are geared more towards teachers and professors. However, he does some interviews with some socially responsible entrepreneurs, people who have developed business like this one, Erin Vargo. She's a power mom and she started her whole business, and it's all about how sustainable her business is, how she started it. So take a look at this podcast if you want. This is a good place to go in, listen to some podcasts. Okay, here's through the Girl Scouts. This lady talks about the Girl Scouts. Here's Pathways to Happiness with another social entrepreneur. So these are social entrepreneurs in the United States and the world. He talks to everybody who are talking about the benefits of social responsibility, building a business that is socially responsible. And we'll talk more about that tomorrow. So take a look at the podcast. Take a look if you want. Come into your class. And if you go under your course content, we are now in the module on social responsibility. Okay, right here. We jumped over financial services. We'll go back to financial services. Let's do social responsibility and entrepreneurship, and then we'll go back to financial services. So we're in the social responsibility and sustainability. Take a look at all the materials. Social responsibility in the news. Things are going on in the news today. There's all kinds of new articles. Why should companies care about social responsibility? Read a couple of these articles before our call tomorrow. And what I'll do is try to give you some more data, try to keep you up to date. This week, we'll focus on corporate social. Next week, we'll focus again on corporate social. And when we come back the following week, we'll start on entrepreneurship. Then we'll go into finances and come back to project management. And then the course is finished. So for those of you who are a couple of weeks behind on the MindTap, take this time now, if you're not working or if you have to stay home from school, take this time to get caught up on any of that. And if you have any questions, please let me know. I'm going to be on my computer. I'm going to schedule office hours so that people can get a hold of me. They know I'm always online. I have nowhere to go in the next few weeks myself. So I'm here stuck at home like a lot of people. And I guess I'm going to do some laundry because this is the only shirt I had clean for today. So it is a nice shirt. St. Pete College. So show your true spirit. If somebody else is hurting or is stressed out, reach out to them. The best thing that we can do right now is to just take a deep breath and know that things are going to get better, and know that we're going to work this out. And like I said, if you can help other people that might need a little extra help, maybe someone that is not familiar with doing online work at all, and you're a little bit more comfortable with that. And the same goes for those of you who are not comfortable with online. You can reach out to your peers and see if there's anybody that can help you also. I'm here for you. I'll help you at night if you're still working during the day, or I'll help you during the day. Like I said, I'm going to post my office hours where I'm always on the computer. The phone number that's on the website for me goes right to my computer, so I can talk to you immediately. We can set up a one-on-one Zoom call. I'm completely here for you guys, and I miss you. This is a great group. You guys have just made some great strides. The projects have been fun to look at and fun to review. And Maybe I'll keep you excited by posting more pictures because I've been taking pictures. So have a good afternoon. Take it easy. I will see you at 2 o'clock on Thursday. Log into the Zoom. If you're having any issues, let me know. Try to start maybe about 1:45. Start logging in so your computer can get up to speed and or your iPhone. And it works great on the iPad. If you have a tablet, it's a great app. It's the Zoom app. Okay, everybody, take it easy. Namaste.